Hey guys, Vaping Vic here, and welcome to another review. Today we are looking at the 4.9 clone mod from Infinite. And without further ado, we will go up close. I'll show you a couple of things about it, a couple of things I've done with it and stuff, and what it looks like and that. And then we'll come back up and I'll talk you through the highs and the lows of this pretty little mod. Cheers. Okay, so here we are up close with the Infinite 4.9 clone, and I'll just very quickly show you the box. It comes in the very standard Infinite packaging here. Little box comes with, it's hard to see there, it might be, but that is your case there, sort of a sleeve, a little velvety sleeve type thing, and then you get your extra tube for if you are using 18650 or 18500, and they go on. And look at those threads, guys, absolutely seamless when you put it together. Absolutely seamless and lovely. You can hear that. You know a good thread, guys. You know a good thread when you see one. And so that is the packaging. Next thing to show you straight away is look how small that is. Look how short it is. Like, it's the length of my finger, guys. And I do not have big hands. It's tiny with this K-Fun on. It is absolutely tiny, absolutely gorgeous. The perfect mod, you know, for out and about. For the discerning gentleman around town, this is your mod, guys. So let's unscrew the K-Fun and put that to one side. Let me know if you want me to do a video on how I build my K-Funs, guys. The next thing I'll show you is the engraving on the switch. Very pretty indeed. It's got this little monkey thing. And all that. By the way, guys, that's why it's called the 4.9, I believe. It's because when it's like this, it is 49mm. And one of the shortest mods ever in this battery configuration. Okay, so brass switch, it gets a little bit patinaed, that brass bit switch, but that makes it even prettier in my eyes. But the first drawback, I'll just show you here, this button, the way you press it, it's so slightly janky, and you can hear it there, it's sort of scratchy. Another slight negative, and you're not going to be able to hear that, I wouldn't have thought, but the battery, because of the nature of it, because the battery has to stay quite loose to be pushed, there is a very slight rattle to the batteries in here as well, and I don't think that matters which battery you get. So, right, okay, so at the top, the reason, one of the reasons it manages to create this size is because it has a hybrid connection on top, again brass, but it's set effectively, that's looking down there into the mod, that's the battery, guys, that is the nipple top on the battery. And you just screw this off and you are in, guys. And that is another factor to be aware of as well. Basically, your atomizer has to get quite far through this hole in order for it to work. Most atomizers do work, but there will be the odd short threaded one that doesn't. Effectively, you put that through there and it pops through the other end, and that's how you get the connection. So that is that. When it is assembled correctly, your battery bounces in there like that, and that is basically how the switch works. You push it up and it does that. On the battery, this is where things get a little bit unique to my situation. On the battery, you put the alternative magnet. This magnet here pushes against the switch, which is a magnet in itself there. And so they repel each other, so obviously you're creating that push on there. Now, let's see if I can not make a mess of this. So this is your battery. All you do is you pop your spacer on there. Now, as it comes with just the spacer like that and another one. But the one it came with did not fit properly at all. It sort of wobbled in the little grooves that you have here. There's a little groove there, and it sort of wobbled in the groove, and it was an absolute nightmare. It also wasn't quite high enough. It was making the throw either really far without it or still quite far with it. You know, it was really frustrating. So what I did is I bought some, I'll just put that back on there, sorry. I'll put that back on there. That's all you do to set it up. I'll pop that back in there. So, gosh. Slightly fiddly, as you can see. Now, so what I did was I bought myself a couple of sizes of these neodymium batteries on eBay, £2, something like that, and you get yourself a set of magnets, not batteries, sorry, what I'm mad about. And they are, I believe, they are 12 millimeters wide and 1 millimeter high. I originally tried these ones, which were 8 millimeters wide, and they weren't quite wide enough either. So I've got two of these additional batteries in my mod that I picked up off eBay just randomly. And I've put those in, and they've shortened the throw for me and made it more consistent. So that has improved things for me. But as it came out of the box, guys, the switch was virtually unusable. It was horrible. But with these batteries in, it's actually getting to the point where it's sort of quite nice now and fires quite well. I'll just put it back together and I'll just show you one last thing. The final thing, guys, is when you're firing this button, it doesn't fire like that. It doesn't fire when you go anywhere near the sides. You want a really nice firm push in the middle. And that is the 4.9 up close. Hope that covered a bit of ground for you guys. We'll go back up top. Cheers. Okay, so that was the 4.9 up close. And I'm just going to get straight into it, guys. I've had a lot of messing around with this mod, but the overall overriding factor of this mod, in seeing the pictures, you can see it up close. You can see how small and beautiful it is in 18350 mode. It's a really pretty mod. It's a really, really pretty mod. If I was drawing a perfect mod for me, the mechanics inside it wouldn't feature in it, but this is exactly what it is. It's got no markings on, it's got nice two little ridges there, brass button, it recessed as well, so you'd have to lock it. It's such a pretty mod. It looks great with a dripper in 18650, and it looks so small and pretty with a little caphon on like this. A 10 out of 10 for looks, without a doubt for me, guys. It is such a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful mod. The original, hats off to the original, guys, and hats off to Infinite for producing a one-to-one replica of this mod. That being said, guys, I cannot get past the switch at all. The switch is a factor. It is not a great switch. Hopefully you can hear that. It's just not a great switch at all. When you press it, now I've done a bit of work on it, adding those magnets and stuff that I bought separately, it's firing how I like it to fire, but it's still, if I don't get it right in position, it doesn't fire. It's janky out of the box. It was really janky and a real frustration. But if you can see past that, you've got yourself a gorgeous mod. It is an absolutely gorgeous mod, and you know, it does everything it's supposed to do, everything it says on the tin, and you've got your three, you know, options of battery size and all that good stuff. The other element as well to consider before purchasing one of these, and it's purely up to you, I can't give you a definitive on this because I'm not selling it, I'm going to keep it. I think it's beautiful, but it's a frustrating mod to use. But the other aspect to remember before picking one up is that the way it has a hybrid connection, and some ATTIs, the screwing in 510 bit of the ATTI may not be long enough to make connection with the battery and the switch and the way it all works. So certain atomizers may not work. To be fair, the K-Funds I've used on here have worked, the Plume Veil worked on here, the Quasar has worked on here. So, you know, there's not too many that I've come across that haven't worked, but it could happen, and I'm sure it does. I'm sure there's a list somewhere on the internet, on one forum, of atomizers that don't work on this mod. Just the really short ones, I'm guessing. And obviously there is no airflow of its own accord from the base either, so it has to be rebuildables really. that you go on here, or anything with its own airflow is fine, but it doesn't have its own airflow. So that is everything, guys. I hope this has been in some way helpful, although I can't give you a definitive answer. Beautiful, slightly flawed is what I would say. A V2 of this, someone taking this, taking the baton and taking it to the next level, could be the mod of the year if someone can do that, because it's the prettiest mod in my opinion, one of the prettiest mods in my opinion, around. So I've been Vaping Vic. Thank you for watching this review. Let me know what you think in the comments. Cheers.